using functions efficiently. Functions are the building blocks of TypeScript as well as JavaScript. In this chapter, we will learn about functions in TypeScript in detail. We will start with adding annotations to the functions. The purpose of using annotations in function is same as using it with the variables. This makes the function easy to use. We will then learn arrow functions in TypeScript. It is an alternative syntax to define functions, mostly the anonymous functions. In TypeScript, function itself has a type which we can define in the function signature. We will see how this works in this chapter. So let's start with our first lesson to add type annotations to functions. Functions are an integral part of modern coding language. Let's have a look how they work in TypeScript and how they are different from the TypeScript's parent language, JavaScript. Here I am at the end of my main.ts file. I have added two functions here for demonstration, demo function 1 and demo function 2. Let's start with demo function 1. Here is a plain old JavaScript function. Looking at this function, it is hard to tell how to use it. It takes two parameters, but what kind? Not mentioned. In such cases, TypeScript explicitly gives any type to these two parameters. You can check out the tooltip here. This means that any values can be passed to the function and will get no type checking support from the compiler. Looking at the function, we can't even tell what value it returns. Let's say if we return a boolean here. To know this, we will have to go through the entire function code. This is not a good practice of writing code. This function in TypeScript can be better written like this. To the same function, I have just added a different name to avoid error in the editor. I have added the annotations here for the parameter. The syntax is same as we have used with the variable. The parameter followed by colon and then the type. This way we can annotate the types for our parameters. And this annotation here specifies the return type. Add a colon after the closing parenthesis, after the parameters, and then the type of the value which the function will return. Let's see more about functions. I'll remove these functions from the demo file. And continuing with the function that we already have here, we will see welcome player. This takes one parameter, name, and it returns a string. But there is no type annotation here. When I hover over this name parameter, I have any type assigned to it. Using any type, implicitly or explicitly, turns off the type checking for a variable or parameter. We need to avoid this. To avoid even accidentally using an implicit any type, we can use the noImplicitAny compiler option that TypeScript provides. For that, we will open our tsconfig file in the root of our project directory. And here we have noImplicitAny option. This option prevents the implicit any type annotation. We can, however, annotate any type to a variable explicitly. This option here is commented out. Let's uncomment this. Now, wherever there is implicit any type annotation, we will get the warning. Let me show you how it affects our code. Here we have an immediate error for this parameter of the welcome player function. Our compiler is running and hence this compiler option has put into effect. Now this will be a quick fix. We know the parameter here will be string, so I'll just add a colon after the parameter and then the string type to annotate the parameter. The compiler is now happy. We will also add the return type for this function. It returns a string. So I'll accordingly add a return type here. After the closing parenthesis, add a colon and then string annotation. I encourage you to use this noImplicitAny option to improve your code. It will be helpful to remind about the missing type annotations on function parameters, which might cause a bug. Now let us see more of functions and parameters in TypeScript.